Oh my God,
I'm being hanging from you anyway.
No.
No. You should make an intro.
I don't have time for that, though.
They go direct. You're right, and I'm not that extra, so.
Do you have one of those, like, animated?
No, okay. That's where you're learning.
Hey, what's that?
Yeah. That quick thing?
Quick thing?
Down, can the line to lie above and their estimates are overestimates. Okay? On 6, F prime does not exist. On 7, F prime would go to 0, have the horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. 8, F prime changes from positive to negative, sorry. Number 9, increasing and concave down. And number 10, just concave down. Mm-hmm. Alright, so before I select results on this, on number 9, if little f is positive, remember big F in our chart goes above little f, it's the antiderivative. So in our chart, what's above positive in our chart? Right? And if little f is decreasing, what goes above decreasing arrow in our chart? Okay. And if f prime is negative, f is decreasing big F. Okay. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and collect up these results from you. Reminder real quick about tutorials today, if that applies to you, I'm going to see you today. We are going to work on some extra practice problems. You will be getting more than one stamp by attending today.
Hello.
Okay? Hello. Absolutely, because this is the last day we're going to have tutorials before your test in 1 week from today. I've said all the things I have. I've gone through it.
Yesterday,
yes? and says is using this information approximates big F of negative 0.5, and it doesn't say in the problem how. Okay? What is the only way in this class so far that we have learned how to approximate a function value without a calculator?
Equation
of the tangent line, right? So y equals x minus x1 plus y. Okay? It's just in this one, it doesn't say write the equation of the tangent line, so I wanted to make sure that we have those in our notes. Okay? Now, the slope comes from big F prime at negative 1. Big F prime is little f. Okay? If big F is the antiderivative, then the derivative of the antiderivative is f. Okay? So what we would do is we have f on this other side here. Okay, so you would say negative 1 to the 4th minus 8 times negative 1 to the 3rd, 16 times negative 1 squared. I'm plugging in negative 1 into the function f that it gave me right here. Okay? Sorry. Now, the number that you get here is 25. So the approximation part, big F of negative 0.5, would be approximately 25 negative 0.5 plus 1. So remember, in order to find the slope of your tangent line, we're going to use the derivative, right? So the derivative of big F is little f. And on the very front of the problem, we were given little f. So then I'm just going to plug right into little f to find the slope. And then that's going to be my approximation. The other one I want to make sure we have in our notes. So, if I know that negative 1 has an output of negative 12, sketch a graph of big F on this graph you have here. Okay? So, I know that little f is always positive. It's really hard to copy, but not very good. Okay, the graph here of little f is always positive. So in our fun chart, that means that big F, the antiderivative, what's the symbol right above positive? Must be increasing. So from negative 1 to 5, I'm going to make sure that my graph goes up. Okay? The other piece that I can figure out from here is when f is decreasing, big F must be concave down. So on this interval right here, okay, I need a function that is increasing and concave down. From 0 to 2, little f is now increasing, so big F must be concave up. So on this interval, I need to draw a function that is increasing and concave up. So something like that. Now, I don't want you to worry about, like, well, my zero is not exactly at 1.5. I actually don't know what the zero is.
going up, and it must be concave. That's it. That's all that I need. Okay?
From 2 to 4, little f is decreasing. So my antiderivative function must be concave.
Down.
So again, I'm going to draw an increasing concave down function.
Oh, of course.
From 4 to 5, F is increasing, so big F must be concave.
So little F is positive all the time, and big F is positive.
I'm just clarifying.
Is it okay?
Don't give her a hard time for her questioning tendencies. Okay? Just let her ask her questions. She's seeking clarity.
That's fine. I know what you're asking.
So this is like going backwards.
It's like going backwards. Okay? Now, it's the same thing with using the chart and moving up the chart instead of down. Okay? So here's what's going to happen potentially on a major assessment that you have next week. So you have a quiz on Tuesday and a test on Thursday. If we gave you a question like this, it would probably be worth 2 points. This question? H. Okay. Is your function, for big F, increasing over the entire interval? If yes, 1 point. So if all you know, Alondra already was like reading my mind, if all you know is this relationship and you decided to just go, if the rubric was, is F big F increasing, then I would say yes, and I would give you a point. The other piece comes from, is your curve the right curve? Okay? So I'm going to look down, up, down, up, second point, congratulations, down. Okay? Now, let's say you don't know the increasing piece, but you figure out the concavity piece. So let's say maybe your function looks like this. Down, up, down, up, right? So you have decreasing pieces in there, but your concavity is correct. You would still get 1 out of the 2 points because your concavity is correct, but the increasing part is not correct. You see how partial credit can be earned here? Avery first, and then Gabby.
So if I wasn't pressing, maybe she would have said,
I would automatically do it.
Yeah, that's where I'm like always making sure you have your nice little chart off to the side and thinking about like, if I know this about this function, what can I also figure out?
Okay.
So let's say from 2 to 4, the function is below the graph. I mean, yeah, below the negative. Then that would
then
be
big F would be because if little f was negative, then the symbol above negative.
So,
but f is never negative.
Big F?
Big. This graph here is never negative. It's always positive. Okay. It's, so that's why big F is always.
So let's say if a so we put the line go down and the left.
Okay.
Okay, like you're good.
All right.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Where does this go?
In
your Gillespie. Go ahead and do that, and then we're gonna transition to some particle motion.
Okay.